Now that we have seen random variables, we're going to talk about what happens when we have two different random variables. This is particularly important because at the most basic level, inference is about using an observation, such as the weather, to reason about an unknown quantity, such as the temperature. Of course, both the observation and the unknown quantity of interest will be represented by random variables. So here we have this probability space with six outcomes. Each outcome has a weather component and also a temperature component. Okay, so for example, the first outcome here is sunny happened and it was hot. Of course, the table here lists what the probabilities are for each of these six outcomes, and you can check that these probabilities do sum to one. Okay, the main thing in this video that we're going to see is that this table representation for the probability space isn't always the most convenient. In particular, we can represent this table in a different way that will often be very useful. What we're going to do is as follows. Think of the weather pieces here. These are the possible values at a random variable W that we've seen before and take on. Now we're going to introduce a different random variable T, which is the temperature, okay? And if you look at this, what we can do is rearrange the table as follows. We can write the weather on one side and the temperature on another to make a 3-row by 2-column table, okay? So we have hot, cold, sunny, rainy, snowy, where we can just copy over entries from this probability space. So sunny and hot has probability 3/10, and then we have 1/5, 1/30, 2/15, 0 1/3. Okay, and this table here has all the information in this table. It's just written in a different way. This table here is what's called a joint probability table, and it is denoted by lowercase p sub capital W capital T. Okay, so this is the joint probability table, also often called the joint probability distribution for random variables W and T. Okay, so for inference, the kind of questions we want to be able to answer is something like the following. Suppose we observe that the weather is rainy. Then we want to figure out what is the temperature. Okay, typically in the class, what we mean when we say what is the temperature is that we want the distribution for temperature. Okay, so a probability that T is equal to hot and a probability that T is equal to cold, given that we have this observation of W being equal to rainy. Okay? Intuitively, what you might think is, well, if I know that rainy happened, then I know that I'm in this row, okay? Nothing else matters because this row happened, so I can't be sunny and I can't be snowy. And you might think, well, isn't this just the distribution for the temperature of 1 over 30 and 2 over 15, given that W is equal to rainy? So the issue there is just that the numbers here, 1 over 30 and 2 over 15, don't sum to 1, okay? In fact, if you add these two, you'll see that they add to 1/6. Okay, so then you can say, well, if I want a probability distribution for T, why don't I just divide each of these two numbers by 1/6, and that'll renormalize this row so that it sums to 1. Okay, and if you did that, you would get rainy, and 1 over 30 divided by 1 over 6 is 1/5. And then 2 over 15 divided by 1 over 6 is forfeits. Okay. So you might think, well, hot and cold, these are the probabilities, given that W is equal to rainy. And it turns out that this is the correct answer for what the probability distribution for T should be, given that W equals rainy. Okay, and in the next videos, we're gonna see more formally how we get to this answer and what the mathematical notation we use is, and so forth.